Hi students, I am Sonia from Vidya Guru. We are starting a new session on current affairs. If you like the session, press the like button for sure. Share the video with your friends and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. If you do that, you will get the benefit of all the exam relevant videos which we upload. We'll start from the very first important question, but I would actually urge if you watch the video till the end, you will be able to retain all the difficult names in your mind because I'm going to help you with the revision. I'll be actually pronouncing all the difficult names twice or thrice. That's how you'll be able to retain the names. Let's start from the very first question. It is about Char Minar, which is situated in Hyderabad and it was adopted by NTPC recently. That is why the question becomes important for us. Char Minar, which is located in Hyderabad, adopted by NTPC, and that NTPC is National Thermal Power Corporation under Swachh Iconic Places Project. Under Swachh Iconic Places Project. But when I actually move ahead, you get to see the whole thing comes under Swachh Bharat Mission of our central government. But here we are talking about something else specifically, that is Char Minar, which is situated in Hyderabad, adopted by NTPC, National Thermal Power Corporation, for the purpose of beautifying it or developing it. You guys understand that, under Swachh Iconic Places Project. BRICS Foreign Ministers meeting held in Pretoria, and Pretoria is in South Africa. Pretoria is in South Africa. I am saying BRICS foreign ministers meet. The question is about the venue of the place, venue of it only. We were saying that we were discussing BRICS foreign ministers meet took place at Pretoria. Pretoria is in South Africa. It was attended by Sushma Swaraj recently. That is why we are discussing that too. Repo rate. From here till here, we are going to discuss the information of bi-monthly policy review of RBI, if there is any change. Yes, the change is there. And let's start from the repo rate. I'm saying bi-monthly policy review of RBI, that's 6.25%. Repo rate has become 6.25%. It has increased by 25 basis points. It has increased by 25 basis points. If the repo rate gets changed, the similar thing applies to reverse repo rate as well. As in, the consequence of repo rate change is that reverse repo rate will be changed too. So I get to tell you that it has become 6% now. 6.25% repo, reverse repo is less than repo. Reverse repo is less than repo. That is why it is 6%. MSF, that's marginal standing facility rate and bank rate. Marginal standing facility rate and bank rate, that's 6.5%. The next question is about French Open. I told you that, see, Rafael Nadal. From here, we are going to start the discussion on the result of French Open. The tournament has held. That means we are going to discuss about the names of the winners. We'll start from the first one, and that's Rafael Nadal. He is from Spain and he has won men's singles. Men's singles. From here, we are going to discuss the names of the people who have won the tournament, as in they have won some title in the tournament. It's like Rafael Nadal has won men's singles and he's from Spain. Simona Halep, she's from Romania and she has won women's singles. The next question is Pierre Hughes, Herbert and Nicholas Mahut. Please understand, these names are actually of, you know, males. Nicholas and Pierre Hughes. Pierre Hughes and Nicholas Mahut, they are males, so obviously they have won men's doubles. The next question is Latisha Chan and Ivan Dodig. As you can see, the name of a male and a female, male and a female, that combo is there. That is why. That means we are discussing the names of the winners of mixed doubles. Mixed doubles, Ivan and Latisha, mixed doubles. Barbora Krejcikova and Katerina Siniakova. Barbora, Krasikova and Katrina Sinekova. As you can see, the names of Katrina and Barbora, they belong to women only. That is why we are talking about women's doubles here. From Rafael Nadal to Barbora, we have discussed the results of French Open. Let's move to the other question. It is about World Ocean Day, which is observed on 8th June every year. World Ocean Day is observed on 8th June. The next question is Central Government Award for Cattle Rearing, Animal Rearing, where we look after the animals, cattle rearing and dairying. Dairying, that means we are talking about milk products. So such things are there, and our central government is providing award for such a thing, and the name of that award is National Gopal Ratna. National Gopal Ratna Award, which was actually given to A. Dhiraj Ramakrishna, which award are we referring to? National Gopal Ratna. As you can read the name Gopal in it, you can understand it is associated with dairying. So cattle rearing and dairying, National Gopal Ratna Award, which was given to A. Dhiraj Ramakrishna. BCCI Award for Best International Cricketer 2016-17 and 17-18, it was given to Virat Kohli. And if we actually talk about this award, that means we are referring to this BCCI Award is basically Polly Umrigar Award. Polly Umrigar Award, which is actually in the memory of Polly Umrigar only, which is actually given in the memory of Polly Umrigar. So Polly Umrigar Award, BCCI Award for Best International Cricketer, was given to Virat Kohli. Theme of RBI Financial Literacy Week 2018. Financial Literacy Week, that means you guys can understand that RBI is doing something of this sort, Financial Literacy Week, which is observed from 5th to 9th June. Which was observed from 5th to 9th June. Apart from that, what you need to keep in your mind, the theme, that the theme was customer protection. The theme was customer protection. The next question is about RBI commits on setting up PCR. PCR is Public Credit Registry. As the name suggests, Public Credit Registry, C means credit, credit means loan. Here I need to tell you the name of the committee first, then I am going to explain it. The name of the committee is Y.M. Devasthali Committee. What is it about? There are people who are actually involved in loans, and they are in the category of good loans and bad loans. You need to understand that there are people who repay the loan and there are people who do not repay the loan. So some kind of repository will be formed under Y.M. Devasthali, that is Public Credit Registry. I told you that RBI committee, that is Y.M. Devasthali committee by RBI, on what? On Public Credit Registry, they'll be collecting the information of individuals and organizations who fall in the category of good loans and bad loans. So according to that, they'll be offered the interest rates also. Such things are going to be there, but they are actually of no use for you because you are studying from the perspective of your exam. The question which can be asked on such a thing is the name of the committee and the expanded form of PCR, that is Public Credit Registry. It is about the loans, I am telling you. It is about the loans. Y.M. Devasthali Committee by RBI, as in that's the name of the committee which is going to take care of such things. Good loans, bad loans. India's rank on Global Peace Index, that's 136. There are places where the rank is mentioned, but that rank is not right. This rank has been given on the website. Website as in the website which actually prepares this index. I'm referring to Global Peace Index, where India got the rank 136 out of 163 nations. The number one rank was of Iceland. The number one rank was given to Iceland, and this index is prepared by Institute for Economics and Peace. Global Peace Index, where India got the rank 136th. initiative launched for raising farmers' income. That's Krishi Kalyan Abhiyan. That's Krishi Kalyan Abhiyan. And this Krishi Kalyan Abhiyan, you need to understand that it was launched by, because at times such questions are asked, that Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, that's the name of the ministry which has launched this. Launched what? Launched Krishi Kalyan Abhiyan to actually help farmers, to help raise farmers' income. The next question is World Day Against Child Labour. That is observed on 12th June. That is observed on 12th June. If you cannot learn the entire name, which appears to be very long, then you can actually learn the thing which is associated with child labour. It is observed on 12th June. Let's start from the first question, which was about Charminar, which is situated in Hyderabad, adopted by NTPC National Thermal Power Corporation. Under Swachh Iconic Places project, BRICS foreign ministers meet Pretoria, South Africa. Repo rate from here till here, we are starting the review, bi-monthly policy review of RBI. Repo rate 6.25%. That means it has increased by 25 basis points. Reverse repo has got changed too because of repo rate. It has become 6%. MSF, marginal standing facility, and bank rate 6.5%. Let's start the discussion of French Open now. Rafael Nadal from Spain won men's singles title. Simona Halep from Romania won women's singles title. Pierre Hughes, Herbert and Nicolas Mahut, men's doubles title. Letitia Chan and Ivan Dodig have won mixed doubles. Barbora Krejcikova and Katerina Siniakova won women's doubles. World Oceans Day is observed on 8th June. Central Government Award for Cattle Rearing and Dairying. That the name of the award is National Gopal Ratna Award, which was given to A. Dheeraj Ramakrishna. BCCI Polly Umrigar Award for Best International Cricketer was given to Virat Kohli for 16-17 and 17-18 both. Theme of RBI Financial Literacy Week was Customer Protection, and the week was 5th to 9th June. RBI Committee on Setting Up Public Credit Registry, that committee is YM Devsthali Committee, which is about the good loans and bad loans. India's rank on Global Peace Index 136, number 1 rank Iceland, and it is actually prepared by Institute for Economics and Peace. Initiative launched for raising farmers' income, Krishi Kalyan Abhiyan, by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers' Welfare. World Day Against Child Labour is observed on 12th June. We are wrapping it up. Thank you so much.